Yarrow is a plant that makes a great ground cover with really delicate fern-like foliage, very, very finely cut leaves. It's not only a popular medicinal plant, it's popular with butterfly gardeners and pollinator gardeners. It attracts nearly everything, all kinds of butterflies, large and small, our native bees. And birds can also eat the seeds once it's done blooming. The fern-like foliage will make a dense mat in either sun or shade and be overtopped by white flowers about a foot tall. Wood ferns are found in the understory of damp woods. They really need protection from full Texas sun, but they have a beautiful shape to contribute to your garden. These lovely lacy leaves, they look really great. Woolly Dutchman's pipevine does grow in North Texas, but it can be hard to spot in the wild. Its heart-shaped leaves resemble those of morning glory, sandvine, and several other vines that grow locally. This one has alternate leaves with a fuzzy underside to the leaf. Almost every time you see it, it will have some damage from the pipevine swallowtail caterpillars. It is their host plant. Plan on giving it a support to climb and letting it twine around other things. The beautiful flowers of the trumpet creeper vine are beloved by gardeners not just for their extravagant good looks, but for their ability to attract hummingbirds to your garden. Hummingbirds love to drink nectar from these plants. They do twine, rather vigorous climbers, and they can become something of a garden bully. Here's one that began to climb a telephone pole at the Herd Museum many, many years ago. It's still there many years later, and you can see as I pan up that this vine has reached the top of the telephone pole, and is quite vigorous in this location. Because the main stems get large and thick, you need to plan a really sturdy structure to plant this plant and let it climb. If they go between the boards of a fence, they can literally push the fence apart. Planning ahead for planting this vine in a place away from valuable structures will pay dividends. It may also help to select an improved cultivar. Those will have fewer root sprouts away from the parent vine. The native type, wild from the field, may have sprouts coming up quite a distance away from the main trunks of the parent plant. You can see how thick and vigorous this vine is. Here it is without the leaves in the winter on a different pole in the same parking lot, again completely covering that pole. The glossy compound leaves make an attractive backdrop for the orange trumpet flowers, and those flowers give way to large bean-type pods. Here's some more of that foliage, and those thick, thick stems again on a different trumpet vine than we saw before. Each one of these is as wide across as my hand. If you really want one, just remember to plan ahead for its full mature size and habits. Carolina jessamine is an attractive vine with yellow flowers that climbs by twining. Be aware that this vine is extremely toxic. It's beautiful and makes great shelter for birds. It's evergreen as well, so those leaves will be there allowing birds escape cover when they need it. This could make a good screening plant since it does make a large, dense, evergreen mass. Though our native bees can use this plant, honeybees have trouble with it. And eating too much of the nectar from this plant can cause honeybees to make toxic honey. So if you live near a beekeeper, you need to keep that in mind when deciding to plant this plant. Most of the wisterias you see in landscapes are probably the Asian types, but Texas has its own wisteria. It blooms after the leaves are well developed, so you may not see the blossoms as much as you do on the Asian types, but it's also much less aggressive and less difficult to maintain in your landscape with equally beautiful blossoms.